from the Sci-Fi for Me studios in Kansas City, this is The Week in Review.
Welcome, everyone, to this episode of Week in Review, our digest of the week's headlines. Here are our top five stories of the week. Item number one, season renewals. ABC coming out with a list this week. 15 shows getting additional seasons. Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. on that list for season four. No surprise there. As well as a confirmation that Grant Ward is now the Marvel villain Hive. No official word on Agent Carter yet, although the website Nerd Reactor claims to have a source telling them a third season has been ordered. As of Saturday the 5th, it's just a rumor. Nothing from Marvel, nothing from ABC. Also on that list, Once Upon a Time, Dan Handley has more with that story.
The ABC fantasy show Once Upon a Time reaches a grand milestone this weekend by airing its 100th episode. The show itself wasn't supposed to make it to begin with. It was premiered on a Sunday night opposite the World Series and the NFL. But it did make it and drew huge numbers. Over the years, it has become more and more complex, and while now it doesn't quite have the numbers it once did, dropping from 12 million households to only 8 million, it still draws enough crowd that ABC, a network notorious for not announcing new renewals until May, has already announced a season six. Congratulations, Once Upon a Time. In Kansas City, I'm Dan Handley for Sci-Fi for Me TV.
Item number two, Joseph Gordon-Levitt has left the adaptation of Neil Gaiman's Sandman, taking to Facebook to explain that since Warner Brothers has shifted the Vertigo Comics projects to New Line Cinema, lower budgets, the vision of the Sandman project has changed enough he doesn't feel like it's a good fit for him anymore. This comes right after the news that horror writer Eric Heisserer has been given the assignment to write the screenplay based on a story by David S. Goyer. Neil Gaiman, who's also an executive producer on the project, posted on Twitter his respect for Gordon-Levitt is undiminished. New Line is hoping for a trilogy. Item number three, SpaceX successfully launches a communication satellite this week. It'll be used to deliver broadband and television channels to Southeast Asia from an altitude of 40,600 kilometers. That's over 24,000 miles. However, the first stage of the Falcon 9 rocket didn't quite make it back in one piece. The company trying again to land on the remote platform floating in the Atlantic Ocean about 370 miles off the coast of Florida. According to CEO Elon Musk, it was a hard landing. They weren't expecting it to go perfectly, but they keep experimenting to find ways to recycle and reuse rocket parts to make the whole thing less expensive. Maybe next time. Item number four, Sony moving forward on the Venom movie. This was originally part of their grand plan for the Spider-Man franchise, which completely fell apart before Sony took hat in hand to Marvel for a co-production on the Spider-Man titles. Avi Arad and Matt Tomac will produce, script by Dante Harper, who wrote Edge of Tomorrow. Maybe Spider-Aunt May is next. One can hope. And item number five, the mashup we've all been waiting for now has a director. Sony in talks with James Bobin, he directed The Muppets, to take on two of their iconic franchises, Men in Black and 21 Jump Street. Yes, kids, this looks like it's actually happening, although for the life of me, I can't tell you why. There is a script by Rodney Rothman. Channing Tatum and Jonah Hill will reprise their Jump Street roles with two new actors on the MIB side. You think Will Smith and Tommy Lee Jones know something we don't? Does anyone think this is a good idea at all? Sound off in the comments and let us know what you think. Now, the rest of the news. Rodney Rothman, we mentioned him just now, he's set for his directorial debut. Universal announcing a release date for a yet untitled R-rated astronaut comedy. They want to make sure you know that. Starring Zach Galifianakis, Bill Hader, and Seth Rogen. In theaters, May 26, 2017. I know I probably pronounced that wrong. They're going up against Disney's Pirate of the Caribbean, Dead Men Tell No Tales sequel. The story, three astronauts discover a mysterious craft, and they learn they're not equipped to represent humankind in a battle of intelligent life. And it's morphin' time for a new generation. Entertainment Weekly posting this first official photo of the new Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. The reboot stars singer Becky G, R.J. Seiler, Naomi Scott, Ludi Lin, and Dacre Montgomery, playing Trini, Billy, Kimberly, Zach, and Jason, respectively. These are the original Power Rangers. Director Dean Israelite says it was important to maintain the team's diversity without the ethnicity-driven color assignments in the uniforms. They'll go up against Elizabeth Banks as Rita Repulsa in the new movie, hits theaters March 24th, 2017. And for more Power Rangers news, check out scififorme.com and our coverage from correspondent Jeff Hackworth. New Regency already giving a green light to a sequel for Assassin's Creed before the first one even comes out. Michael Fassbender signed on to continue as Callum Lynch. And just so we're clear, the movie, set to hit theaters in December, is telling an original story in the universe of the Ubisoft game. So there's plenty of room, apparently, to make a movie franchise to go along with the video game franchise, because that's what you do anymore. Earlier this week on the H2O podcast, Mr. Harvey and I discussed a lot of the casting news for pilot season. ABC has just announced, on top of that, Gina Torres will top line The Death of Eva Sofia Valdez, comparing it to Macbeth with a Cuban twist. Torres plays the title character, ruthless, ambitious, and when she gets humiliated in public, gets the help of three mysterious women of supernatural origin, and you know it will end in tears. Devious Maids showrunner Charisse Castro-Smith writing the script, executive producing along with Agent Carter showrunners Michelle Fazekas and Tara Butters. And for American Horror Story Season 6, Lady Gaga has confirmed she'll be back. In an interview with New York City radio station Z100, she said she doesn't know how or when, but she's in. Now, Variety contacted FX for comment, but the network has yet to confirm. So, it's official according to Lady Gaga, but not anybody else. Sci-Fi moving forward with a post-apocalyptic thriller called Aftermath. It's a 13-episode Canadian series they're ordering. Noreen Halpern's Hellfire Entertainment has produced this. It'll air on Sci-Fi this summer. A family of five battling for survival in a world after civilization comes to an apocalyptic end. Like there's any other kind these days. The apocalypse, of course, triggered by massive storms, meteor strikes, earthquakes, plague, and the rise of supernatural creatures. Halpern says, and I quote, "Nothing captures the human imagination quite like fantasies of our own destruction." No word on whether or not dogs and cats are living together. Personally, I prefer my human imagination to focus on more positive stories, which is why I'm not watching any of the political debates. Politics at the center of Han Solo's identity crisis in the new Solo title from Marvel Comics, Han Solo, that is, a 5-issue miniseries by Marjorie Liu and Mark Brooks, with a story set between the events of Star Wars and The Empire Strikes Back, where Han doesn't quite know who he is anymore. His internal conflict flares up when Leia asks him to transport a team from the Rebellion, because she doesn't trust anybody else. But there's this race he's been dying to enter his whole life. What's a scruffy-looking nerf herder to do? You can find out starting in June. And for other Star Wars news and rumors, check out Salacious Crumbs right here on Sci-Fi for Me TV. And finally, you remember that game show you used to watch when you were home in bed with the flu? Why not make it a movie, right? Nickelodeon announcing during the upfronts this year, Legends of the Hidden Temple will return as a TV movie inspired by the game show. The story, three siblings have to get past a series of obstacles to stay alive. And elements of the game show will be in the movie. Olmec, the talking head, the steps of knowledge, green monkey, red jaguar, silver snakes, and such like. Isabella Moner, known from 100 Things to Do Before High School, stars in the film, directed by Joe Menendez and written by Johnny Yumanski, Zach Hyatt, and Alex Reed. That's in the fourth quarter of 2017. Can't wait. All right, that's all, folks. If you have feedback or a news tip, you can share that with us through email. We can review at scififorme.com, or you can leave a comment here. If you like what you see, give us a thumbs up. Please share with others. You can also subscribe to our channel, and you can sign up for our monthly newsletter. It goes out the 15th of the month. Plus, you can register to get an email when we post new content at scififorme.com. Of course, you can find us on all the social media. Our podcast, Sci-Fi for Me Radio, you can find on iTunes, Stitcher, podcast.com is where we host those. And that's it for this week in review. Thanks for watching.